Hello viewers and welcome to another episode of SMC DAO tutorial. On today's tutorial, I will be giving you an introduction to BSCScan.com. BSCScan.com is the site that we use to do researches on wallet addresses, contract addresses and smart contracts, transactions, transaction hashes and a whole lot more. So let's get right into it. Tap right there on your preferred internet browser and search on BSCScan.com. So this is the homepage of BSCScan.com, and at the top left corner you can see the logo of BSCScan, and it indicates that BSCScan.com is a product of Etherscan.io that you can use to search on transactions done on the Ethereum network. BSCScan is particular to the Binance Chain Network, and Etherscan.io is particular to the Ethereum network. A video on how to use Etherscan.io to do researches would be out on our YouTube channel. So tap right there and turn on notifications and subscribe to our page if you aren't already subscribed. Now you can sign into BSCScan.com user interface if you have an account, or create an account if you don't have an account. Next up, we can see the search bar, which you can use to search for addresses, transaction hashes, blocks, contract addresses, smart contracts, and find out what exactly happened with these addresses on these transactions and on these blocks. If you scroll down, you'd see the current price for BNB, which is $301.91, currently at 0.0069 BTC. Now, the reason that BNB price is being shown is because BNB is the native coin for BSC network, which means that every single transaction that you make on the Binance Chain network receives taxes in BNB. So the current price of BNB is very important to note on your researches. BSCScan.com also shows you the current BNB market cap on BSC, which is valued at $7.2 billion, right, at 24 million BNB. Now, this $7.2 billion accounts for the amount of BNB currently on-chain on BNB. It doesn't account for those BNB that is stored or kept or traded on CEX or centralized exchanges. It also shows the transactions that have been recorded on BSCScan.com, which amounts to 5.3 billion transactions, which is a lot, at 50.1 transactions per second. The gas price also is recorded there, which is 3 gray, valued at $0.02. It also shows the latest block that has been created at 3.0 seconds and the voting power. The BSC Smart Chain transaction history in 14 days is also here, which shows from January 18 to the current date. If you scroll all the way down, you would see the latest blocks and the latest transactions. But let's get right into it. What is the use case of BSCScan.com? How can we use it, and how can we understand what we see on the BSCScan.com? So you can paste an address that you want to search on. It could be your address, it could be a person's address, your business partner, or anybody, even a contract address, to be sure that you are buying into the right coins. You can do that using BSCScan.com. All right, so we'll scroll all the way down, and it shows the BNB balance in this wallet, which is 0.003 BNB, and that BNB is currently valued at $1.11. It also shows the value of the token holdings in this wallet, which is $34.93. Now, we must be careful to ensure that we understand that the BNB value and the token holding value are different. Token holdings accounts for all other coins that are in the wallet apart from the BNB, and BNB value accounts for only the BNB that is in that wallet. And on this wallet A2, we can see that it is $1.1. This shows us that there are 85 tokens on this wallet. So if you want to search for tokens that you may have lost on your wallet, you can use BSCScan.com to check for the tokens that are in your wallet and you do not know about. So it shows the highest holding, which is BSC USDT, Coin Muna Coin, and some other coins that are here. So if you scroll down, you'd see that there are coins that do not have values attached to them. This is because BSCScan has not yet attached value to these coins, although they can be traded and they can be used as coins. If you scroll down, you'd see some other coins that are tagged as suspicious, unsafe, and spam. These are tokens that have been added to your wallet mostly without your permission, and they are unsafe to trade because they could make your wallet compromised. If you tap on view all holdings, BSCScan.com has to verify that your connection is secure, and then it shows you all holdings on this particular wallet. It shows from the highest valued ones to the least valued ones. It also shows their value at $1.1, $30, $1.29, and all the rest that are shown here. So we'll go back to our page. We are doing a research on this wallet to see the transactions that have been done in it and understand how to do research for transactions on a wallet. So if you scroll down here, you'd see transaction, internal transactions that have been done on this particular wallet, the tokens transferred in BEP20 on the BEP20 network. They are also recorded and put in an array on the BSC scan. And the analytics, which gives a rundown of the money spent, the transactions that have been done on this wallet in a simplified format that can easily be understood. It also shows the multi-chain portfolio, which shows all the coins that you have in this wallet on different chains, you know, that is seen on the wallet. Let's go back to transactions. The most recent transaction appears at the top and the least appears way below based on your setting. The last transaction shows us the transaction hash, the method of transaction, and there are many different methods of transactions on networks, which could include transfers from a wallet to another wallet, multi-core, swap, and all that, approval, creation of contract, addition of liquidity, removal of liquidity, blacklisting, whitelisting. There is a whole lot more that can be done. Then you can see the age of transaction, and it shows you that money had left this wallet that we are doing a research on out to BUSDT stablecoin. It also shows the value of this transaction in BNB, which means that no BNB was attached in this transaction. It shows us that money left from A2 to BUSDT stablecoin, and it wasn't a BNB transaction. So to find out what exactly or how much exactly left into BUSDT stablecoin, how much of BUSDT stablecoin was bought by this wallet, tap on the transaction hash. Remember that BSC scan can also be used to check transaction hashes. And the transaction hash here shows the status of the transaction, that it was a success. For a transaction to be a success means that it has been validated and it has been put into a block for easy access and recording on the blockchain. So it also shows the timestamp of this transaction, which is 1 day and 21 minutes ago. And now we can see the transaction action. We transferred $57 to a wallet right here that ends with ADDE. All right. So if you scroll down the transaction hash, you can see that the wallet left this wallet that we are researching on. and interacted with BUSDT stablecoin, and it left to the wallet with the last characters as ADDE, and the amount was $57. It also shows the transaction fee, which was valued at $0.03, and the gas price. More detail shows that the gas limit bonds fees and the code for the transaction that is written right here. We chose the function as transfer, the recipient unit amount, and the method, you know, that is shown right there. So if we go all the way up, we can do a search on the coin that was bought, which is BSCUSD. The max total supply, the holders that are currently in the coin, which rounds off to about 13.9 million on chain. The total transactions with BSCUSD, which is almost a billion transactions. The price, which is, since it's a stable coin, the price is $1.00 worth. The market cap, circulating supply market cap, and other info. So this is simply how to use your BSCScan.com to do a research on a particular address that you want to know what happened, how the transaction was sent, where money was sent from, and where it went to on a particular wallet, you know. So it's very easy. You can check the outs, the ins, so you know when money comes into that wallet or when it leaves that wallet. If this video has been of help to you, tap right there on the like button, subscribe to our YouTube channel, and turn on post notifications to be the first to get any of our tutorial videos that we release. See you in the next video. Goodbye.